Hello. How is everybody doing? Good afternoon. Good evening. Good morning. Let us know where you're watching from. I see some Vancouver. I see some Cole Harbour, Nova Scotia. It's beautiful to be here. Let us know how you're doing on a scale of 1 to 12.5. I'm probably at about a 10. 10 out of 12.5. There's a prize for whoever is feeling the best. Yeah, I can see there's Jacqueline's excited for today's guest. I also am very excited as well. I've been trying to get him on since the very start of this whole singular shenanigan. Can you have a singular shenanigan? It's Mr. Leif Volbeck. We're going to bring him in a couple of songs time. And yeah, I'm going to play a couple of things. Going to play a couple of things first. Negative six, Jacqueline. No. Okay, let's see if we can get that number up a little bit. Hiya, Sarah. I'm going to start with a new song that I've been working on. It's been a little bit of a crazy time. Oh, Happy New Year also. This is the first show of the new year. It's been a little bit of a crazy time in terms of moving apartments, coming back from tour, getting COVID. So I haven't been so productive on the writing side of things, but this week it's just kind of started again. So I'm getting back to exploring things. I did play this a few weeks back, but yeah, I'm going to spend a bit more time with it. This is called Sledgehammer. Sledgehammer for all you people watching out there. Yeah, so good to see the folks watching. Hello to Halifax. I don't know who Sam Martin is, chappas, but thank you for letting me know. I'm gonna play a cover of one of our most frequent guests on here, Mr. Michael Fierstek, a friend of myself and Leif. So this is partially for him as well. It's my favorite song of his that he released on his album a couple of years ago. It's the first track, it's called Love Is All Around. Yeah, and if you're enjoying the stream, if you like what's happening here, feel free to share it on whichever platform you like. But yeah, for now, this is a Michael Fuhrstack song.
It hasn't been your time. The world has been unkind. Although the body wills, magic flows from the gentle part of you. A candle makes no sound, quiet in its power, strong enough to light the way. All the while, death is just a breath away. But love is all around, drifting on the sound waves, rippling through the muddy water on its way to the will to simply be. It comes reluctantly. How long can you hold on? Smothered in the shade, drowning in the light. But love is all around, drifting on the sound waves, rippling through the muddy. Your muffled sound, I called on everything I could to help you let it out. The darkness of your song has made your sentence long, punctuated by light. All around, drifting on the sound waves, rippling through the muddy water on its way to you.
That's Love Is All Around by Michael Fuhrstack. Thank you for saying hello, everybody. It's nice to see all the folks watching. I can see a lot of people are excited about our guest. So why don't I just bring him in? It's the one and only Mr. Leif Volbeck.
Hi. Leif. Can you hear me?
How's it going?
Good. Thanks for setting me up.
You're here.
It's like a... What are we, 2 years into the insanity, and this is my first live stream?
We did it! We made you do it.
Yeah, thanks for the setup.
How are you doing?
I think I'm okay. Yeah. I'm more confused. I can't believe that it's working.
So. Well, is this plenty of time for it all to like really go horribly wrong? So, you know,
well, it did.
Let's not get too excited.
10 minutes ago, it did. All this stuff. I don't know what's wrong with my gear. I don't even know why I have gear. I don't know how it works.
Yeah, you're better off with just like an acoustic guitar.
I know.
Like me, right? Except I've got like a bunch of microphones and computer and streaming nonsense.
That's a Martin, right? Or is it?
I wish. It's a Cort.
Oh, it sounds amazing.
Oh, thank you. It's got very old strings on it. I think that's maybe part of the trick.
Yeah, that guy at Broken Headstock, he saves all the all the old dirty strings.
Yeah.
And he gives them to Brad.
Is So he's this, like, is,
oh, this is he just had a hand. What's that? He's like, oh, it's all these old strings for Brad.
We should give some context for the folks who don't live in Montreal. Broken Headstock is a guitar store here, and I'm assuming you mean Brad Barr here from the Barr Brothers.
Yeah, because he's got all the old strings.
He likes the old strings with his old guitars. This is a thing though for some people, because like there's a studio here in Montreal, Mixart, that like Plants and Animals do a lot of stuff out of, and I was recording in there, and the engineers were like, "There's all these beautiful guitars, but they've just got really old strings on them." Just like, same thing.
In a good way.
No, I think the engineers are like, "Come on, like put some new strings on it." But I think like Warren likes his old strings.
Yeah, I mean it's. We could. How boring do you want to get? Because I could talk about that for an hour. The worst is that like I've got guitars that got 10-year-old strings, and then one of them breaks, and then you have like this,
that's a problem. Well, this is like a thing with
the one shining one
that just like pokes out. Brian Eno, yeah. I think, has a guitar that only has 3 strings, precisely because of that. Because every time the string broke, he wouldn't want to put a new one on, so he just kind of like let it just run out of strings.
Sounds kind of lazy. I read like a couple years ago that you know, when you're Paul McCartney, like I don't know, like most of what he says, he must be aware that like a million people are gonna read it and scrutinize it, so maybe he's a bit guarded. But he said like the major difference when he made it was that he just doesn't change his own strings anymore. That's it. Like right. I'm still the same old, but I'll never change strings again. like someone else does it for him. Like he's not keeping old. He just someone else puts the new ones on. I don't know. I just thought that was. I just changed the string today, so clearly I'm totally fucked.
Is there like one thing you can think about this? You don't have to answer this right now, but if you like quote unquote make it in on a Paul McCartney level, which is I guess is like that's the biggest level there is pretty much. But is there one thing that you would change like that? That you're just like, I'm not going
to
do this again.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I would get Paul McCartney to change
that. Nice.
I think.
Beautiful. And we're getting a lot of folks saying hello. If anybody has any questions or requests for Leaf, I mean, I'm not saying that Leaf is going to play your requests, but you can ask him questions and he might answer. We'll probably answer your questions. Maybe, do you want to give us a little tune? Is that something that you'd be interested in?
Yeah, I think so. It's probably better than me talking.
Now we'll get back to that. Don't worry.
Thanks for having me, Tim.
It's my pleasure. My absolute pleasure.
Thanks for bringing me into the internet.
You belong here.
I was just like, well, just use my phone, right, on 3G? And you're like, that's not how this works. I was like, oh, shit. Okay, I'll try. I'm going to play a song called East of Eden, which wasn't the one I was going to play, but then I felt like it. Is that okay?
You are my guest, literally.
Okay. Thanks. That guitar too loud? Is that okay?
Got the jack of diamonds, you got the nine of hearts. The cards get stuck together, it's so hard to pull them apart. I think your face is showing. Ain't the first time that it's snowing. The first time in years that it has stayed on the ground. When it hits the street, it don't make a sound. So there's just no way of knowing. Thank you. just like a book, and I don't want it to end. Take it with me where I go, turn the pages slow. She's just like a book, don't want it to end. I love how we talk at night. I love how we talk at night. The blue electric light. Love how we talk at night. I love how we talk at night. The blue electric light. No, I'm not the only one. No, I'm not the only one. At least I'm not the lonely one. No, I'm not the only one. No, I'm not the only one. At least I'm not the lonely one. Do what you would do.
What's that?
You're dealing with an amateur. Was that okay for the levels? Was that all right?
We could ask the people back home. It sounded pretty damn good to me. It sounded beautiful to me.
It's called mono microphone technique.
Yeah. That's the trick. Single microphone.
Yeah. The opposite of what I would want someone else to do is what I have to do.
It sounds amazing. It sounds beautiful. We're getting, yeah, sounds great. Sounds very good.
Oh, yeah? Okay.
So
oh,
beautiful.
Very good.
Yeah, very good.
Very. Okay. Well, I liked it better when it was great.
It's acceptable, terrible. No, not really.
Yeah.
Talk to me.
So you see comments. Is there a reason I don't see comments? Was I supposed to turn them on?
No. This is a very convoluted process where Leaf is coming through us through the very familiar to many of us medium of Zoom. And I'm using like this streaming program to kind of take that Zoom and send it out into the world. And the comments are coming in through that other program. So it's very complicated. And the people watching back home saw me kind of like mess up the frame. And so all of a sudden your picture just like went like that for a second. So
that's cool.
My apologies. It's pretty cool. It's like, you know, I can do terrible stuff like that.
I'm into that.
Lynn says, wow, so amazing. Hot tears, ! Which is a request that you can do if you want to, but you don't have to. And then we did get a question as well from Mark, who wants to know, well, I guess it's to both of us. Do you guys have COVID albums in waiting to release at this point, not expecting Dan Romano level output, which is good because only Dan Romano can do Dan Romano level output.
Even Dan Romano can't do Dan Romano output.
It's like an album every day.
Yeah.
From Dan Romano. You did release a single last year.
How long was last year?
About 17 years, I think.
17 years.
It's so.
What was last year? Last
2021.
Year was 2021.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks. yeah. Oh, yeah, thanks for noticing, Tim. I put out a live song last
year. Well, no, but. Okay, yeah, I guess I'm thinking 2020 then in that case.
See?
Yes.
See, you're. Yeah, it's just one. It's just the 1 year now. It's just the 1 year.
The time before years. The
you
time
know what?
After years.
It's hard. I don't know. That's a great question to that guy. It's a great question.
Yeah.
We'll find out if there's a record in here somewhere.
Oh yeah.
Nobody knows. Nobody knows.
But like that, I'm totally blanking on the name of the single now. Blue Light.
Long Blue Light?
Long Blue Light. I want to say Pale Blue Light, but it's not Pale Blue Eyes. Long Blue Light.
Yeah, which is, it should be Pale Blue Eyes, but it was taken.
Linger On, Long Blue Light.
Linger On, exactly. I couldn't do anything about it.
But that was such a magic song because like I remember just like walking around my apartment and I found myself singing this melody. I was like, oh, that's a nice melody. And I was like, oh, that's that Leaf song that I've heard once. Like after I heard it the first time, like in the next week at some point, it just popped into my head and like the whole thing was just there. It's just like... It's like one of those songs that's like, that is just, it's just right, you know? That song is right, Leaf.
That one's probably stolen. That's probably if it's any good. Should I try another one?
I suppose. I want to talk about strings more, but I suppose you could play another song if you want to.
I'm just nervous about my levels. You know, you'd be like, go ahead, and I won't be ready, and I'm like trying to...
Get everything just perfect. Right before you do, a little bit of housekeeping for the folks back home. If you like what you're hearing, there is a support link in the video description. You can support through PayPal or Interac if you're here in Canada or credit card. So please support generously, but any small amount helps us musicians who might never play live again. We'll find out. Over to you, Leaf.
Thanks, Tim.
Lost in the meadow, you just have to stand. And I looked for the farmhouse, it was covered in sand. Fire of the moonlight mm-hmm. nothing white. Sometimes I just close my eyes. And I dream it one night. Annie, loving Annie, come give me your hand. They said that if you marry, the roving of her eyes. I knew my love was changing by the roving of her eyes. Summer with a bottle in my hand, saying, drink with me, my Annie, for our love's at an end. We'll go down to the water when everyone's asleep, and I think of love. The roving of her eyes. Knew my love was changing by the roving of her eyes.
When you clap it, I can't hear it, so I just see like silent clapping, which is kind of like a nice metaphor for the last 2 years.
I have to confess, I did like once realize that I could clap silently when I was at a show, and I thought the music was really bad, but I didn't want to be seen to be not clapping, so I realized like, oh, if I do this, then I won't look rude, but I won't be like adding to the sound.
You won't be betraying your inner.
Yeah, I won't be lying. There won't be clapping lies.
It's very layered, Tim. It's very layered.
Also, I feel like I've revealed something dark.
No,
about...
I think many of us have been in your position and might not be so forthcoming.
Admitted it publicly. Constance says Bonnie Light Horseman. I guess that was a... Did you do a little Bonnie Light Horseman thing at the end there? Was that what was going on?
Yeah. Hi, Constance. Yeah.
Hi, Constance.
I did because... It's the best record of the past. It was the best record the year it came out, and it's still the best record since it came out.
I've not listened to it.
Do you know that record?
No.
Do you not know that record?
Okay, I'm going to go and listen to that right after this.
Yeah.
In fact, I'm just going to end the stream right now.
What's that? So
I'm just going to end it all right now.
Yeah, just make sure you don't like have anything. You're not near any like ledges or anything, because once you hear it, you might be like, I need to end everything because it's a perfect record. You know? It's so good.
It's hopeless trying to match this.
Like the recording is perfect, the songs are perfect, the drums are perfect, the bass is perfect, the lyrics are perfect.
Okay.
It's just like, it's one of those rare things that happens when music is perfect. It's perfect. And I don't know. I wonder if it's tape. Because it's usually not perfect if it's not tape. But
it's probably a tape plug-in over the top of everything.
You'd think I'd know. I'm such a nerd. I know quite a bit about it.
There was actually a question read exactly that kind of thing. Matthias wants to know what reverb you use.
Right now?
We want to get nerdy. Strings, what, right reverb, now? We'll talk about everything. Sure. I assume he means right now. Oh, like, do you want to answer the question right now? Or do you want to...
Oh, I meant, like which reverb
in this performance.
Am I using right now?
I assume so, what? Yeah.
I'll tell him. But I don't know if it's what he wants to know. Like, on the Moog, it's a Flint Strymon, which mm-hmm. is this bass player and artist, transhuman. I don't know why I said transhuman. I meant, like, transcendental human.
Mm-hmm.
Shahzad Ismaili. I think that's how you say his last name. He's the one who he played bass on one of my records.
Okay.
On Twin Solitude. And he also brought a Moog. This one here, the Moog mm-hmm. Rogue. And I don't know if you can see me touching it. And I asked him to play bass on my record. And he showed up and he said, I also brought a Moog and I'm going to be playing Moog on your record. <as well." laughs> And he was so confident and positive that he was going to do it. I thought... Well, great. You know, that sounds great. And like, he was so confident, I there was no way I was going to doubt him. And he did. He played some White Noise on Eastern okay. Eden, and he played a couple other things. Anyhow, and he introduced me to the Flint Strymon, and it's okay. Very expensive. and it sounds great, and it's the only reverb that this is really boring, but it's
no,
the only
I'm into it, and I think other people are as well. Actually,
it's like. I'm boring. I mean, like, but it's the only reverb that if I put it at its maximum, it lasts long, but it doesn't last forever. And it's like the only reverb. Any other reverb I try doesn't. Anyhow, so it's. I don't know. Anyhow, it's so weird. But that's yeah. And it has like this. It sounds great. You know, I don't know.
And the guitar, the guitar reverb.
Guitar. I don't know. I think it's just on the amps. It's just just the Fender amps.
Fender,
hey, Fender,
reverb.
You want to give me some money?
Fender, if you're watching, Mr. Leo Fender, if you're watching, please send Leaf an amp and a bunch of money. And then Karen wants to know if there were songwriters that were big influences for you growing up, that stood out as you were growing up.
I wasn't expecting such like wonderful like. I thought I'd just be playing, and you know, usually when I do live streams, I just play and I'm like just I don't know what's going on. Anyhow, that's nice, Tim. This is very nice.
Well, I thank no, the viewers.
No, there are no songwriters that have inspired me. I listened to a lot of Radiohead, and Beatles, and then I got into Bob Dylan when I was 16, I think. That's kind of it, really.
Yeah.
And then Prince and all the other things, but you know, and Leonard Cohen and all that stuff. But growing up was a lot of Radiohead, actually.
Interesting.
Yeah. Mostly Radiohead.
Me too, to be fair.
You too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. It kind of, that was the band that, but, you know, like, I think for our, well,
yeah,
I don't know.
Our
I
generation
so.
A little bit, yeah.
Well, if you're learning guitar and it's 1998.
Which
you know,
we were.
Which we were. And then it's just like, it just blows all the other songs out of the water, yeah. Kind of like. You know, because you there's it actually sounds like a record when you play their songs. You know, the open tunings or the you know the riffs and stuff. They really like carry.
Yeah,
they kind of transport you to record land. You know,
I feel like Tom Yorke is always doing like chords where it's like just some kind of suspension in there, just adding one extra finger in, and just
yeah.
So you learn that chord and you're like, whoa, like I'm a really advanced guitar player because I'm playing not A minor but A minor with like this. Thing somewhere else, and but then you can learn like the crazy Johnny Greenwood solos, and it's like there's
yeah.
all these different layers of things to pick out.
Yeah, that was what we did in high school, just picking out the Johnny Greenwood yep. versus the Tom York stuff. Yeah, yeah. I assume that you were thinking about exit music for a film when it resolves to the sus4 to the major. That's what you were thinking. Yeah.
Go through all of those chords, yeah.
Was
yeah,
that
we know.
You were
we're
is that why you
that.
Did the sus4 there?
Could be.
Or were you thinking more?
Or like that chord, that like. Come on. I mean, I don't even know what that is.
That's a G and minor that. 7 with the sus4, isn't it? Oh, that's
sure.
a good one.
Whoever plays
There's
that?
No way that
Nobody
people
plays that.
Want to hear us talk about that.
Let us know if you want to hear us talk about this, people. I do. A few folks have been saying it's been really nice to have the two of us playing, and it's been a long time because I'm going to show you this because I've probably like posted this on Facebook at some point, but that poster that's like just a little bit too far away to see.
Oh yeah.
But
oh
didn't
God.
You
yeah,
do that poster actually?
When did we
didn't
that
you design
show?
That poster? That was like 2009 or something.
I'm that
ridiculous.
We've been alive that long.
We've been alive that long. Because I think maybe you designed this poster, no? Didn't you draw this thing?
Oh yeah, I drew that. Yeah, I drew that. I think that was supposed to be Serge Gainsbourg.
What do you mean it supposed to be? It's quite obviously Serge Gainsbourg.
I can't tell if it is. Oh, John McKeel.
Yeah, back in the day.
That was it. We played that show in Halifax, didn't we?
No, that was Montreal. That was the Bread Factory. And that was industrial space in St. Henry. And that was the first time that I met Greg Burton, who, when I moved to Montreal, I moved to Greg Burton's house. So I probably wouldn't be in the city without that show. So,
wow.
There you go.
Holy moly.
Yeah. Those were the days. Those were the days.
Remember legal gatherings in locks. Let's not talk about it.
No. Play me a song. Play me a song, Leafy.
Cool. I'll play another one. I could try that. It's a little tricky. I just don't know. I could try that Hot Tears song. I could try it.
Ooh,
I
love that
it.
One. That's one of my faves.
I mean, I should know how to play it. I just mean that my setup is a little bit.
Yeah.
I mean, so when it falls off the rails, you'll know. You'll know.
I'll take responsibility.
Someone won't. It won't be me.
You just made Lynn very happy.
Maybe I'm just drawn to wonder. I can feel it coming. Do you hear the night? From the river bridge, I hear the thunder. Either storm your skin or mine. Tell me what's the story, my morning glory. I can feel it coming. Do you hear the night? Telling me all the time I'm sorry. Baby, don't I know it? It ain't hard to tell. Well, I know. Yeah, I know. You get so low, but you get high before you go. Come say hello. Cause I'm never gonna find a way to say goodbye. Hot tears. Lightning evening in the holy highlands. Down in the hall, up against the wall. I know you're struggling what to call it. Why you gotta call it anything at all? Is it a dream or some softer poison? As looking away till they bled the blues. Is it a dream or some softer poison? As looking away, as looking away. Well, I know. Yeah, I know. You get so low, time before you go. Come say hello, 'cause I'm never gonna find the way to say goodbye.
I was really cocky. I thought, oh, I'll just move the capo down, and everything will be in tune. And it was not. That's how that's gonna go.
That was beautiful. Thank you for doing that. That's definitely one of my faves. So I'm quite personally glad that one got
in
there.
Why? Thank you, Tim.
And you got a lot of positive responses to that.
Oh, that's great.
I feel like I had one other. There's lots of questions. There's so much stuff that we could talk about, but I should say for folks that don't already follow Leaf, if you follow him on Instagram, he actually does quite a few like sporadic like Instagram live things, and they're fantastic because you just start and kind of like go into all these different covers, and it's beautiful. It's like it feels so kind of just you're there in that moment, and I know that you haven't done a lot of like these YouTube type thingies, but it's A+ for folks watching back home. Go find him on Instagram, and I don't know, go find his music everywhere in general.
Thanks, Tim. That's so kind of you. Thanks for having me on and getting me out of my my comfort zone or into my new comfort zone.
A new comfort zone. Yeah. I'll take that. No, it's been a pleasure, and I knew that it would be really nice, and I'm so glad that you did it.
Thanks so much, Tim. Well, have a great everything.
We're going to say goodbye to Leaf, everyone. Say goodbye. Give him some wavy hands and hearts and stuff.
Thanks so much.
And I'll see you in real life somewhere soon.
Exactly. Thank you.
Bye-bye,
so
Leaf.
Take care. Bye.
That's Leaf Volbeck, everybody. I'm going to keep going and play a few more songs here, if that's okay with you. Stephen, I'm glad that you're up to an 11 out of 12.5. Me too. I definitely feel a lot better after that beautiful set from Mr. Volbeck. Go and check out his stuff. I think Leanne was asking how we met. And it was through a mutual friend of ours, Francois Levesque, in Ottawa when Leaf was living in Ottawa. And I played the opening party for this magazine, Apartment 613, and Leaf showed up there and gave our cello player a lift back to the place that she was staying, and then we played some shows together in out east in Nova Scotia, New Brunswick. I remember that was when I used to tour without a mobile phone and without a computer, which the promoters didn't really appreciate. And the first time we went to go and play a show together, I had to pick Leaf up in Moncton, and I think I showed up about 4 hours late without any kind of communication of the fact that I was that late. So I apologize to Leaf out in the world there. Sorry, Leaf. I'm gonna keep going. I'm gonna play a couple of songs from the last record now. Maybe I'll give you some crickets to keep you entertained. I'm gonna play one called Grace. Which is about messing up and then receiving kindness in response to that. This is such a pleasure. If there's anything you want to hear me play, get it in the comments. I'm going to do about two or three more. And I'm open to your suggestions, so let me know. This is Grace.
Still, we tell ourselves that nothing ever changed so much. I see it all, the grace that you hold. You send me out in the cold, oh, too cold. Is it enough? There's infinite sin. Don't ever cast a stone before you. All of us are fickle and unmoored. At least you're not. All the things you're not. Could there be anything that you would rather hear? Bless. I see it all, the grace that is stone. You send me out in the cold, oh, too cold talk. As much as you'd ever own, you send me out. You send me out in the cold. It's not
Grace. Oh, we're getting all kinds of requests in now. Rob wants to hear Better on acoustic. Rob, I have a guitar with a pickup in that I don't have with me this week. If you tune in next week, I promise you I will play you. I'll play you Better. Lynn, I don't know if I can play Flicker. It's been that, it's, you know, some things are just part of the past and maybe they need to stay that way. I'll have a go also in the middle of the week and see about that for next week. So I feel like I have to do some of those other requests now. I could do Ren. I could do Ren for you when you and then maybe I'll have a go at Watch Me Go. I'll have to see if that's plausible, and I'll do a Radiohead one. Okay, that's three songs. That's three songs that are gonna carry us through. Maybe I'll do I'm gonna do one for myself first. But yeah, then I'll have a go at Ren and maybe some Radiohead and maybe Watch Me Go if it's plausible. Ted, so nice to see you're watching. And again, if you want to support the stream, there is a support link in the video description. Thank you so much to everybody who's been supporting. It does mean so much. It's kept this thing going for 2 years. It makes a huge difference. And I love doing it, so anything that helps me to do it makes me very happy. I'll press the little button that kind of puts the link on for Twitch as well. This is a song called All We Know from the last record, and it's about being a little bit oblivious to the the good things that you have that are close to hand. And it's for Grandma. If she's still watching, she's probably gone to bed at this point, but this is for Grandma. All we know, isn't it? So many comments today. Irvis, I don't know how to say that. Irvis. I don't know any Smashing Pumpkins, but there is a Billy Corgan cover of a Bee Gees song that I will also learn for next week if you tune in. I should have said before as well, I do this every week, but it's on Wednesdays usually. So make sure you subscribe to the channel if you don't already, like the Facebook page, the Twitch page, whichever platform you're watching on. And Wednesday next week, I'll be back at the same time, the same place next week with the fantastic Jenny Burkle. So you can listen to her stuff in advance to get ready. Forgot what I was gonna do now. I'm gonna do Ren, because that was a request from forever ago. As in, I wrote it in like 2006 or something. This is a song about being lovesick, I think. I'm not even totally sure. Leaf and Tim should tour together. That'd be lovely. One day. But, you know, who knows about touring? Leaf is supposed to be touring in the spring, so keep your eyes peeled for that in case he's coming close to you. You know, hopefully it will actually happen. Okay, this is a song I haven't played and even thought about in a long time. It's called Ren, and it's for, I forget who requested that now. Wen Yu. This is for Wen Yu, and who's watching at like 4 a.m. in Taipei. Thank you for that, and for watching every week, Wen Yu. This is Ren.
Thank you.
That was Ren taking it way back. That was, yeah, a bit of nostalgia for folks. That takes me back to like playing the Bus Stop Theater in Halifax in like 2009. Happy times. Yeah, this is great. Wonderful request. Bringing it right back. Thank you so much for everybody who's been supporting with the tips and the supports. And just for being here and watching. Thanks again so much to Leaf for playing. That was wonderful. Such a treat to have him on here. I'm going to play one more. Karen shifted from Radiohead over to Tendril, so I'm going to play that. Oh, and Irie Wiss is Raphael. Hi, Raphael. I'll just stick with that. That's much easier to say. It's been a treat. You've been lovely, as you've been every week. I'll see you next week on Wednesday, not Thursday. Back to regular Wednesday times. And yeah, if anything comes to mind in the week in between, send me a message if there's something you want to hear. I'm going to finish up with Tendrils here for Karen, and I'll play those requests that I promised next week. I promise I will. I promise. Yeah. Tendrils.
Blocking all the holes, hide inside walls, decided to go. Come silence, don't pick apart its source, make it up and just put it aside. Don't find us waking upside down, find your sense, hold it. It watch it unfold. Phrase tendrils creeping for a hole. The steely gray glow of your eyes. But by night I'm silence and still. Can you make yourself feel unkind? When you cry. Misinterpret words, deflect us from the side of you, drenched and afraid. Fight in the sourness that pulls around the brain. It's an offering, again. Sealed inside each verse, up above my words, you've ascended. I'm sure that's as true as any for the times I had tried but didn't make the connections, and I'm left to feel. If I was you, I lie. 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 Picking apart your eyes, fooled by the scope and pulls rope. Oh, judgment, picks apart your eyes. We barely are truthful to us.
That was Tendrils. Thank you so much to everyone for tuning in. I do want to show you this one thing because I tried to do it earlier on and the button didn't work properly, but I spent so long doing it that I feel like I want to show it to you. I made a little name thing for Leaf. Leaf! So exciting, right? So disappointing that it didn't work at the time that I wanted it to work. Damn it. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I'll be back here next week. Wednesday, 3:00, Montreal, 8 p.m. UK, 9 p.m. Central Europe, and I'll see you then. Bye-bye.